Hi my YouTube babies. So it's been a minute, right? So what happened was, you know what? Life happened. And I finished my classes. No, I actually didn't post it, but I finished this semester with 95%. Yeah, I was so excited. So, guys, excuse my messed up nails. These are my Christmas nails that I need to fix it because now we're in 2020. Happy New Year, my YouTube boobies. So, on my channel, I'm going to start doing a lot of different things. So, I was reluctant to... So, you guys are going to see the keto... let's talk, and I had some talk Tuesdays that I didn't post. Went to Virginia, a lot of things happened in my life, and here we are. So in 2020, step goal number one is to be consistent regardless, because I hate giving you guys excuses. I hate giving myself excuses, and I actually enjoy doing this. Now that I have, I finally got a little hard drive. So it makes it easier for me to edit. It's actually much faster, and it makes it more encouraging to do these things that I'm doing. So I have changed, and now you guys, I created an intro. Cute, huh? Okay. So I have been serious. I was about to pay somebody on Fiverr, but like, you know, and I decided to change the channel to Creativity Paradise because I don't just do talks. I don't just do makeup. I don't just do food. I do all of those, including some dance videos, including some everything. But I wanted to come to you guys because it has been an emotional 2020 for me. Actually, ringing in 2020 was not the way that I wanted it to be. And it left me feeling childish and stupid. To tell you the truth. That's how I brought in the new year. And I almost felt like this year is going to be sucky because see how I brought it in. I had that such into my head that like how you start the new year is how your year is going to go. But... forget that. I'm not going to put that on top of me because God is in control. And I wanted to bring you guys some things because I just go to school. I am now a stay-at-home mom. Only take stay-at-home mom / student. And I am trying to build myself up. You know, we made that decision that like since I'll be taking 5 classes and I have a newborn, well, she's 5 months, she's still kind of new, you know, but it'll just be best for us to do it that way. So in that, I'm like, okay, I'm in school and my major is entrepreneurship. I love helping people when it comes to business ideas and just what they got going on. So this video is to encourage all of my 2020 hustlers this whole YouTube thing, because I know I'm not big in it and I'm not, you know, most people usually do these things, but we all can eat, y'all. I'm trying to figure it out, and if what I'm telling you could help you, even though I'm a little challenged, then let me help you, boo-boo, okay? One, I've noticed that you want to have a proper banner. And to get a proper banner, what I used was the app Canva. Canva is awesome. Canva and Poster My Wall have been the best things for me. I've used them to make thumbnails for videos. If you guys notice, my thumbnails have been a lot better than before. I'm still learning, but they've been a lot more clear and a lot more, you know, clear cut. On my phone, I have an iPhone 10, I mean iPhone X, and I use the portrait mode to take a good chunk of my pictures. When I'm taking food pictures, then I usually use regular, but if I'm gonna take my own picture, I usually use portrait mode, and in portrait mode, I have a few settings. So those things usually help to kind of get you a clearer picture. Make sure you are in good lighting. Right now I'm not in the best lighting, but if you can see, there's I'm not trying to show y'all. I'm in my house. But like, as you can see, if you come up, the lighting is much better here. But because I'm just like on my bed trying to have a chit chat with you guys, because I told you guys y'all gonna get these Let's Talk videos as much. That's another thing, I changed it from Talk Tuesday to Let's Talk. Another thing that you want to do if you are, you know, doing YouTube things, is you make sure that you put in your channel tags. So your channel tags help people find you. And it's mainly for your channel, period. So it's just for you to pop up in anybody's search when you search. I usually use, you know, I use plus size, I use dance, I use Nigerian, I use African American, I use woman. I use all of these things because all of them pertain to me and what I do. I put cooking, I put keto, I put health and fitness, I put weight loss, I put beauty, I put everything I do in that channel thumbnail portion, just so that everything is covered, and that just makes it easier for people. And I feel like you're shooting yourself in the foot if you don't put it there, because it kind of gives you a one-up. Like, it's the thing about search engine optimization things, you want to put as much of what you're doing in everything. So the thing is, if you're going to put a title on your video, that's another thing. You want to make sure that you put a title that makes sense. Oh, you don't want to put "Hooray for Christmas time" when you're going to do a vlog about Christmas time. But in that vlog, you know, you can put something like, you're doing a vlog about decorating your house during Christmas time. So, you know, you can put Christmas decoration vlog or something like that. Not, you know, holiday time, fun time, or you know what I mean? Like, things like that. Because what are the odds that somebody's going to look for holiday fun time? What does that even mean? They'll look for holiday songs, look for holiday recipes, look for holiday decor, but they will not look for holiday fun. Sorry. Don't lie though, because I hate when people put things in their video that they don't even talk about. Like, spilling the tea on Instagram. You know, and people be interested because they be like, oh my goodness. People do, oh, Instagram is what you call it. Instagram is scamming people and things. No, Instagram is not scamming people. In her whole video, the only thing that she said was that she posted something on Instagram as usual, because we are all into social media. You know, like, don't lie. So don't lie as like clickbait for people to get to your videos, because you will lose a lot of followers. And first impressions. That might be the first video somebody ever saw of yours, and they never want to become a fan because they'd be like, this girl lied. I thought I was going to see something juicy, and I saw nothing. You know, like, so don't lie. What else? You want to make sure your thumbnails are bold. Using those apps really does help. You want to make sure that your content is clear. See, I'm filming on my phone right now. Usually I use my camera, and I have the Canon C7i, and that's the camera that I use. I'm still learning, but after seeing Patricia Bright's video about, you know, what she does on YouTube, I'm considering getting the lens that she has, because it's true, lenses are expensive. But if you see, you guys will kind of see that, like, in my holiday and New Year's Eve haul, it kind of was, I was very far back, but still you didn't see clearly, and it's simply just because the lens doesn't capture a wide amount. So that's something that I learned, that cameras have different types of lenses, but these are something for later on. So right now this works for me. Like, I do my dance videos with my phone or with my Canon, but usually with my phone, because it's easier for me to do something like that that's quick. And that's kind of a tip that I have, that like, sometimes we want to do this whole production because we're trying to get into YouTube and we're trying to get all these followers and all these subscribers and all these people. But at the end of the day, people just need a clear video. Like, you guys can see me here and hear me clearly, so this is perfect. You know what I mean? Like, yes, the lighting is not 100% better, but you'll get better with things like that. Like, if I have my ring light, I went and bought a ring. My husband, actually, for Christmas, he's really bought me a lot of things for this because I said I wanted to do it. So he's like, you know, there you go. I'm not a photographer, I'm not an editor, but I can give you beats and I can buy you equipment. So I'm grateful to him. So he bought me, you know, a selfie light camera. So some of the things that I have, I will link below with my Amazon affiliate link, so you guys can click on it and see the things that I have. Because honestly, I didn't just get an Amazon affiliate link because I wanted to get one. I got it because I use Amazon. Like, for keto, I use Amazon. For business, I use Amazon. Almost for everything. I'm the type of person that I'll order something all the time. All the time. My husband will be like, you got a whole bunch of boxes. Your house always looks like Christmas. I don't know what it is. I just always need some. And Amazon, that, you know, that Prime, they get you. Get a sister. So it is what it is. But those are just a few things when it comes to starting. Like, I feel like, one, just do it. Get a video, even if it's not that clear. Can people see you? Can people hear you? And can you get a clear message across? Do it. I also learned that sometimes it's good to be more organized. I am very whimsical. I'm not very particular about things, but I've noticed that it helps a great deal when you are organized, because then when you want to talk about something, you know exactly what you want to talk about. If you want to just spontaneously do things like these Let's Talk videos, I just kind of go with it. Sometimes I write down a couple of key points that I don't want to miss, but for the most part, I just wing it because that's my personality. But sometimes I've noticed that it goes a lot better and a lot smoother. If you have points, you elaborate on that point. You have another point, you elaborate on that point. You have another point, you elaborate on that point. And you have them written down in front of you. Because if I have a notebook right here, you guys can't see it. Like, you can't see where my hand is. So you can go ahead and, you know, look down and read so that you can talk. I mean, like, at the end of the day, these videos should be well thought out. Though you're bringing content and you are being creative, but in your creativity, you still need a process. What else did your girl learn in this year of 2020? If you enjoy writing and blogging, get into blogging. Blogging can actually help big time, and there's ways that you can endorse your blog to where you have ads on your blog, and that also gives you revenue on top of, you know, if you get reputable enough, you end up doing commercials, you end up doing other, you know, you end up doing ads that people, like, you know, other stores will send you things so that you can, you know, input them into your blog. And sometimes the best thing, some people feel like they have nothing, but sometimes if you are a stay-at-home mom like me, that's your blog content. Every day with these babies is something different. And, you know, you speak to new moms. I mean, like, being a new mom, you get to speak to them. Being an experienced mom, we new moms love to hear from you. You know what I mean? Having multiple children, having a husband that travels, being a single mom, you know, like, you have a lot to offer. So put it out there. If you like writing and you like storytelling and you could put it into words, do it. If not, vlogging too, getting into YouTube just like this is another thing. So sometimes having your YouTube relate with a blog also helps, you know, and things like that. And there's plenty sites that will help. Like, there's Blogger, there's Wix, what else is the other one? There's Blogger, there's Wix, and if it's something like getting fit, you can become a health coach and start a health coaching site if you just took your health to the next level. You know what I mean? Like, keto is hard for some people. I mean, like, some of us, like me, I could read something and do it. I am a, what you call, a see and do type person. A lot of things that I learned how to do my makeup on YouTube. I learned how to do my natural hair on YouTube. I learned almost everything on YouTube because I'm just that kind of person. You know, but some people, it just doesn't work like that. They read it, they comprehend it, okay, they didn't comprehend it. They read it. And that's about it. They just read it. You know, and like sometimes it's like that. When you, everybody's had those classes where you read and you be like, what? I gotta read that sentence again because I read it, but I was thinking what I'm gonna eat for breakfast. Like, it happens. So sometimes some people, it's just not that. And if somebody's telling you and explaining to you, coaching you, guiding you through, you become more successful that way. So if you know that you were one of those people like me that you could read something and start doing it. If you love to cook and people are always telling you that your things, have people try some recipes. Right, I log recipes all the time on my fitness pals because I always want to get the most accurate thing, and I cook all the time. I enjoy cooking it. That's why I say creativity paradise. I just love creating things, and that's another outlet, food. And you know, if I create a bomb keto recipe, you know what I mean? You can, of course, post some and help some people out. But also, if you've taken all this time to be posting it, put your best recipes in a book. Things that you know people are looking for. You know, for keto, if you can find a good bread, okay? Chips that ain't pork rinds. Creamy baked mac and cheese with some cauliflower. I've done that. We might have it either. Well, no, actually, I did that on my Instagram story, so you can go ahead and see that. And then, you know, like, comfort foods. Like, things that are for holidays. Things that you know people will take to banquets. Desserts that people don't see all the time. Sometimes it can be the simplest thing, but just because your concoction. And sometimes, you don't even have to reinvent something. You don't need to invent something totally. You just need to reinvent something already existing. Maybe you tried a keto bread, and the keto bread was good, but it wasn't bread. So you start experimenting with some flours and some ratios, and you get a bomb bread from somebody else's. You know what I mean? And that's the same way. That's the way technology and all these other things work. Somebody made the cell phone before Apple decided to make a phone. Android made a phone. All these people made a phone. Quest had phones. Everybody had phones. But now, you know, like, iPhone is classy. You know what I mean? Android is best. Google is wonderful for pictures. You know what I mean? Like, everybody has their theme, and they're just tweaking little things that the other person doesn't have. And sometimes that's all it is. And one of the biggest lessons I learned in my entrepreneurship classes is that sometimes the best ideas and the best businesses come from a problem. You find a problem that people have, and you fix that problem. What problem do some people have that need to be fixed? What issues do some people have that need to be fixed? And how could you be of help to them? What is an issue in something that needs to be fixed? Whatever it may be, you can do it. Those are my tips. I hope you guys enjoyed it. So stay wonderful, stay positive, stay blessed, stay beautiful, and I love you.